हेलो चिल्ड्रन, इन लास्ट पीरियड वी सॉ कम्यूटेटिव प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ एडिशन। अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस प्रॉपर्टी वी विल गेट द सेम आंसर वेदर वी एड 2 + 3 और 3 + 2। द ऑर्डर डजंट मैटर। इन दिस पीरियड वी आर गोइंग टू सी द एडिशन ऑफ 2-digit नंबर्स। फर्स्ट वी विल सी द ऑब्जेक्टिव। To enable student to add 2-digit numbers with and without regrouping. Second, to enable student to apply the knowledge of addition in real life. Children, where do we use math in real life? We can use it for counting money, for shopping, for distributing things, for sharing, or for making teams while playing. We will see here one example. Let's consider we want to add 45 and 22. Now these 45 and 22 both are 2-digit numbers. So while writing these numbers vertically, vertically means like this, standing, we need to take care of place value of each digit. Place value is the value of a digit according to its placement in the number. Means, in this 5 and this 2, both these are at one's place. So while writing, they should come below each other. Means below 5, we need to write 2. And this 4 and 2, these are at 10's place. So now we will add this. This is 1's place and this is 10's place. Always start adding the numbers from right side. It is the 1's place. This is the right side. This is the 1's place. So always start adding the numbers from this side. So 5 and this is 2, we have to add and the answer is 7. Now add this 10 side or 10's place digit. This is 4 and this is 2. So the answer is 6. So the addition of 45 and 22 is 67. Let's see one more example here. We have the number 36 and the other number is 21. So this is 6, is it at 1's place? 1 is also at 1's place and this 3 and this 2, they are at 10's place. So again we have to start adding the numbers from one side. So 6 plus 1 is 7 and then this 3 plus 2 is 5. So the answer of 36 plus 21 is 57. Now children, before this we added 45 plus 22 and we got the answer 67. Now we added here 36 plus 21 and we got the answer 57. This is simple 2-digit addition. This is simple 2-digit addition, which you can do easily. It is called addition without regrouping. This addition is called addition without regrouping. Now children, we will see addition with regrouping. Now what is this addition with regrouping? Regrouping in maths is changing groups of ones into tens to make addition or subtraction easy. What is addition with regrouping? Regrouping in maths is changing groups of ones into tens to make addition or subtraction easy. In addition, we regroup when the numbers we are adding come out to two-digit numbers. We will see this with example, then you will understand what is mean by addition with regrouping. Here we have the first number 15 and then the second number is 17. We have to add these 15 and 17. Now this ones place and this is tens place. This is ones place and this is tens place. So for this we will use here bundles. Now this one bundle means 10 sticks. One bundle means 10 sticks, or we can say one bundle means 1 tens. One bundle means 1 tens. So here is 1 tens. So here we take one bundle. And here at ones place 5 number is here. So here we will take 5 loose sticks. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now in this 17, at tens place 1 is there. So again we are going to take one bundle here, and at ones place 7 is there. So again we are going to take 7 loose sticks. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Now we have to add this. So for this, first we are going to add this right hand side, means this loose sticks. So how? This is 5, this is 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So here we got 12 sticks. Now children, we can write 12 here? No, because this is ones place. So here we got 12 loose sticks. From these 12 loose sticks, we can make one bundle of 10 sticks. See here, this is one bundle of 10 sticks. Here see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yes, this dotted line is showing one bundle of 10 sticks. And we make this bundle from this combined 12 sticks. Because it is fine, because 10 loose sticks is equal to one bundle. This 10 loose sticks is equal to one bundle. Now I am going to move this bundle from here to here, because this is ones place. Here we cannot write two numbers. So I move these 10 sticks or one bundle from here to here. Now see, this is one bundle, this is second bundle, and we moved one bundle from here to here, this is third bundle. So here we got 3 bundles, means 3 tens, and how many loose sticks are here? 2. The same thing we will do here. Here is at ones place 5 and here is 7. Now if we add this 5 and 7, we know the answer. The answer is 12. The answer is 12. But this one is at tens place. This is ones place. So we cannot write here two numbers. So I am going to move this one at tens place. Okay, right. Because we have only one place here. We have only one place. to write, and of that one we moved it on the tens place. Then we continue doing the counting of tens place. This is tens place. Here this one plus this one, two tens, and this more one we are going to add with this. So here how many ones we got? Three. Okay, this is this one plus this one, two, and this is this one. So we can say we moved this one from here to here, or we can say we carried out or carried over this one. We can say we carried over this one, and we got the answer 32. So what we did here? Here first we were having 15 plus 17 numbers. So we added this 5 and 7. We got the answer 12. From that we moved this one from here to 10th position, and then we added 10th number and we got the answer 32. Now children, let's see page number 52 of your maths textbook. Open your maths textbook, page number 52. And you have to solve these questions with me in your maths textbook. Here, one shop, Mr. Chandra's shop is here. Mr. Chandra has a shop. There he sells sports goods such as footballs, chess boards, badminton rackets, and shuttlecocks. He wants to know the available stock of goods with him. Help him by solving the following questions. Remember to add ones first and then tens. Always remember, add ones first and then tens. See question number 1. Children, you have to solve this question with me in your textbook. The first question is, he has 68 shuttlecocks with red feathers and 21 shuttlecocks with white feathers. Children, whenever we are going to solve the word problem, this is a word problem, read it carefully, try to understand the meaning and then solve. For that, you have to read the word problem at least twice. Now see this, he has 68 shuttlecocks with red feathers and 21 shuttlecocks with white feathers. How many shuttlecocks does he have in all? What we have to find out? How many shuttlecocks does he have in all? No. First, we will see what he is having. He is having 68 shuttlecocks with red feathers. Then, 21 shuttlecocks with white feather. These two things he is having, and we have to find out how many shuttlecocks does he have in all. Means we have to find out the total number of shuttlecocks. Here, the total number of shuttlecocks. So, we will solve this. First, see here, this is 68. In this 6 is at 10's place. So, I am going to take here 6 tens. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And this 8, it is at 1's place. So, I am going to take here 8 ones, 2 plus 2, 4 plus 2, 6 plus 2, 8. Now, this is 68. Here is 2. Is it at tens place? So I am going to take here 2 tens, 1 and 2. And this 1, it is at 1's place. So I am going to take here 1 1's. Now we will write this in the box. This is 10's and 1's. And here we are going to write the number. This is 1's place. This is 6 is at 10's place. This is plus sign. Then 1 which is at 1's place. And this 2 at 10's place. Now we have to add this. First we will add here and then we will write the answer. Always start adding the numbers from right side. Right side means one side. So here if we count this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How many ones we got? 9. So here 8 plus 1, 9. Now we will count or we will add these tens. This 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How many tens we got? 8. Means 6 plus 2, 8. So children, Mr. Chandra is having 89 shuttlecocks in all. How many shuttlecocks he is having now? 89. Now see question number 2. This also you have to solve with me in your maths textbook. The question is, he has means Mr. Chandra. He has 54 footballs and 36 basketballs. He has 54 footballs and 36 basketballs. How many balls does he have in all? We have to find out how many balls does he have in all. So again we will do here. He is having 54 footballs, 36 basketballs, and what we have to find out? Total number of balls. So here 54 means 5 tens and 4 ones. So again I am going to take here 5 tens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 4 ones. This 2 plus this 2, 4. In this number here 3 tens. So I am going to take here 3 tens. 1, 2 and 3. And here are 6 ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now we will write this in the box. Tens and ones. Then first ones place 4 is there. Then at tens place 5. So the number is 54 plus and then the next number is 36. So we have to add this. Now again we will add here and then we will write the answer. These are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. If we add these loose ones or if we add these ones, then we got the answer 10. So we can write here 10. No, because this is ones place. So here we can write only one number. Here we can write only one number. So if we see this number 10, this one it is at tens place. This one it is at 10 place. So we will move this one from here to tens position, or we will carry this one from ones position to tens position. So see, we moved this one from here to here. Now here 4 plus 6, 10, and we moved 1 from here to tens place. Now we will do counting of these tens. Now this 5 plus 3, 8, and plus this 1 which we moved from this ones place. So total is 9. What we did? We added this 54 and 36. First we added 1's place, 4 plus 6, we got the answer 10. But this is 1's place, so we cannot write here two numbers. So we moved, we carry this 1 from here to this 10's position. And then we added this 10's number and we got the answer 90. Or you can say 9 tens and 0 ones. Okay. Now children, see question number 3. If he has 37 yellow counters and 38 red counters. If he has 37 yellow counters and 38 red counters, find out the total number of counters in his shop. So again we will write what he is having. First, he has 37 yellow counters. These are 37 yellow counters, and then 38 red counters. And what we have to find out? Total number of counters. We have to find out the total number of counters. So again, see here in this 37, 3, it is at 10's place. So I am going to take here 3 10's, 1, 2, and this 3, and 7, it is at 1's place. So here 7, 2 plus 2, 4 plus 2, 6 plus 1, 7. Now this 3, it is at 10's place. So again I am going to take here 3 10's, 1, 2 and 3 and 8 1's. 2 plus 2, 4 plus 2, 6 plus 2, 8. We will write this in the form of box. So first write here 1's number, 7, 10's number, 3 means 37 plus this 38. Again, always add number from right hand side. So this 7 plus 8. So we will do here counting. These are 7, then 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. We got the answer 15 here. But children, we cannot write here 15 because this is 1's place and this 1, it is at 10's place. So now we will move this 1 from here to 10's position, or we will carry over this number here. So we are going to move this. Then here is 5. Now we will add this 10's number, this 3 plus this 3, 6, and we will going to add this 1 with this. So here is 7. What we did? We added this 37 and 38. First we added 7 plus 5. We got the answer 15. Then we moved 1 from 1's position to 10's position, and then we added the numbers at 10's. So we got the answer 30, got the answer 75. Now children, today's homework. Page number 54 and 55. This is your today's homework. Okay? Thank you.